If that's true, then I'll put it to good use.
I suppose we'll see. I've stolen enough of your time, my dear. Don't let me keep you. Yes?
What the fuck? She's like, what do you think about my new moves? You like them? I call this one the fade boogie.
I wanted to ask you about the Circle of Magi.
Of course. What do you wish to know?
If the Circle disbanded, how can you still belong to it?
The Circle is an idea, my dear. And an idea cannot be dissolved. Many of the first enchanters voted for rebellion, caring little that anything short of a unanimous decision would pit mage against mage. Rather than dissolving it, Grand Enchanter Fiona's vote split the Circle in two. The rebels follow her, the loyalists follow me.
Man, this is lame. I didn't know Vivian was a fucking loyalist.
If you led all the loyalists, why are you only First Enchanter and not Grand Enchanter?
Grand Enchanters are elected, and since there are no First Enchanters besides myself, no vote can be held. I could name myself Grand Enchanter, but the title holds no meaning now. When the circles are restored, that will change.
I've never been to the Montsamard Circle. What was it like?
A place of great history and tradition, with the greatest library of magical history outside of the Imperium. It was deeply involved in the Great Game, as you might expect of anyone living in Orlais. The mages there were quite competitive, but it was stimulating to be always pushed to exceed the abilities of my peers.
How did we come to this state with the circles in revolt?
You, my dear, are far too wise not to have realized that many of our colleagues live with their eyes closed. Safe from the world inside their towers, they thought only of the Templars and their own resentment. Kirkwall gave the world a reason to remember its fear of magic. A mage killed hundreds with a snap of their fingers. Across Thedas, a new tangible fear of magic grew. Commoners and nobles alike called out to the Chantry for protection. But the malcontents in the towers thought nothing of this. They cared only for themselves and for their anger at the new Templar restrictions. When a mage attempted to assassinate Divine Justinia, again, the mages protested the investigation. The leadership chose to vote on independence based on the intolerable conditions imposed by the Templars, sparing no thought to the fact that magic was more feared in the aftermath of these attacks than it had been since Tevinter's day. So long as they had their freedom, they could care little for riots, angry mobs, or about pitting mages against each other.
Are you familiar with Grand Enchanter Fiona?
We've met. Before her horrendously ill-timed and selfish vote for independence, I thought her adequate at her job. In her dotage, she could not handle looking after the well-being of so many people. We would have done better to replace her years ago, to let her spend time gardening.
Did they have cause to rebel?
In the aftermath of their terrorist attacks? Was that really the most opportune time to break away? By all means, protest abuses by the Templars. Just don't do it in a way that says mages support wholesale murder. By voting when they did, my colleagues all but declared war upon the ordinary people of Thedas. A war in which we are outnumbered 100 to 1.
I thought the fighting was only between mages and Templars. Why are mages fighting mages?
The vote for independence was carried by only a small margin, but Fiona chose to let the motion stand. Those who opposed a rash declaration of war against the entire free world had little choice. By breaking from the Chantry when they did, the rebels declared themselves in support of mass murder. Anyone who did not wish to support terrorism and the slaughter of innocents was forced to take arms against the rebels. Yes?
Oh my god! Welcome!
Yes.